Hello my friends, and a very warm welcome to another tutorial using the fabulous Lavinia stamps. I'm calling this one Awakenings, and it's very much inspired by one of my favourite artists and a piece that she did called Amanda Clark, and I'll put the link for that in the description box below. She produces these beautiful spiritual, ethereal, mystical pictures, and I wanted to have a go with that. It's not as realistic as I usually do, but it's more symbolic. So I hope you enjoy the tutorial, and without further ado, let's have a look at the materials used for today's project. Okay, to begin, we're using the Elements ink pads in Sundance, Truffle, Della Blue, Mulberry and Merlot. I'm also going to mix in Distress Oxide and Cage Flamingo, and we've got our Versamark stamping pad for embossing. We've also got Chianti in the Versaclair Permanent. A couple of pan pastels, titanium white and also violet. You could also use your pencils or your sticks. White gesso, some paint, this time it's a gold colour, any brand will do. I've got some detailed white embossing powder, anti-static bag for some stamping, and I've also got Posco pens in yellow, dark red and pink. I've got a Stabilo All black pencil, a purple colouring pencil and a white gel pen, some stickles in magenta and diamond for some sparkle. I'm using my lovely Lavinia stencil brushes and also some makeup brushes and a paintbrush. The paper today, or the card, is multifarious from Lavinia Stamp, and it's a wonderful card. Now the stamps, Lupin silhouette and also Logan silhouette, also the hazel tree, the red pine in large and the skeleton tree in large. Some little foliage stamps, the small branch, one from the Twisted Vine set and another from the Flora set, and of course the gate and the fence. So if you want to convert these into something a little like this, just keep on watching.
Thank you. Thank you.
So now that the sparkle is dry, let's take a closer look. You can see how the leaves twinkle. I didn't fill in all of them, but you get the idea. And of course, as I said earlier in the video, you don't have to go this far with the picture and add as much detail as this. You could stop at any stage, and you don't of course have to put the fence across. I just fancied putting that in as an extra detail. And you can see all the little leaves, which are really just little dashes added with the white gel pen. So I hope you enjoyed the project today and you'll have a go yourselves. Please consider subscribing if you haven't already done so. And thanks to all of you who have provided a donation under Super Thanks, which the link is below the video. I so much appreciate that. It really encourages me to make more videos. So do look after yourselves until next time, and thank you for watching.